Hello friends, welcome to Akul Mac Live. I'm Kanchan Varma and today we are taking you to a wonderful city. A city which is being ranked number 3 among the top 10 destinations for travelers. But before that, I would like to remind you there's a free gift available only for you. Stick around to this episode till the end. We'll guide you how to avail your free gift. Hello friends, welcome to our show today, and we have a wonderful guest today who will be discussing about a wonderful city. And the city is said is being settled around 723 BC, and this is also a city which is called a city of temples. And again, it is earlier it was called Kantipur because this city used to be very, very beautiful. So without wasting any further time, I would like to welcome our guest today, Mr. Sitesh Srivastav. So welcome to the show, Sitesh. How are you doing today?
Thank you, Kanchan. Have a great day ahead. And it is always lovely to talk to you, especially about the places where I have visited, which I cherish. And I want to visit again. With almost like a great big expensive lens, and hearing from the people about the culture, the history, and probably rediscovering. And thank you for that. How have you been?
I'm fine, and I look forward for a very wonderful discussion about the city. So I just maybe bust the mystery. We are discussing about Kathmandu and why Kathmandu. I'll just tell you before you start your wonderful experience with the city, that the Kathmandu is shaped like a ball. And once upon a time, this was a lake, and in this lake there used to be a lot of snakes who used to live. But there was Manjushri, the king by the name of Manjushri, who cut this valley and drained all the water, and thus it was created city Kathmandu.
Well, Kanchan, this is amazing, and I have seen Kathmandu being very close to the Nepal border, where I used to stay a small place which is called Raxol. It is a border town on the Indian side. On the another side is a town called Birganj, and there was a road, in fact, made by India many years back when we used to stay at that side. And I have traveled to the wonderful Himalayas, and I can proudly say that that has been my first international visit when I was still in the school times and later as a teenager. So Kathmandu is actually a kind of a spiritual capital, not just a physical modern day capital, but a spiritual capital of the Nepal territory. And it compasses a lot of great traditions, cultures, religions, art, and together from the Tibetan, from the Hindus, from the Chinese, from the Buddhism, and of course from some of the Asian populations. And it is actually an ancient valley, and it is amazing. Not only because of its beauty, but it has got lots of UNESCO World Heritage Sites, and one can spend a long, long time about experiencing the mystique of Kathmandu.
Right, and it is said that it ranks third in the traveling destination, which is being declared by few travel agencies. And so I would like to know more about this wonderful city.
So Kanchan, till 1950s, Nepal was kind of isolated from the international travel circuit, tourism circuit. And from 1950s onwards, there was an effort to open up the Kathmandu as a cultural capital of South Asia or Southeast Asia, as we can say. And then the world discovered about some great places like Darbar Squares, Hanuman Dhoka, and Pashupati Nath, Swayambhu Nath, and Tribhuvan International Airport. And there are many, there are a lot of alleys in the city. There are a lot of art and architecture spread across the city. And mostly they are around the gods and the goddesses. And this is a city which the moment you land there, you feel that you are very, very close to Shiva, our Lord Shiva. And Pashupati Nath has been one of the very, very oldest and very active Jagrat kind of a temple.
Yes, and I've also heard there are many temples which are dedicated to Ma Durga and many more devis in this place. So I also want to tell our viewers that Shri Krishna is also closely associated with the city Kathmandu. So if somebody is planning to go to Kathmandu, what is the duration which is best to stay there and look around?
Well, a person depends on the traveler, international traveler, what they want to see. I believe that a lot of tourists which go from India, they have an interest in looking around some of the very, very old and very active traditional conventional temples. And then there are other international places, tourists which come to see the natural beauty, the history, the World Heritage Sites, and UNESCO heritage sites. But, you know, Kathmandu is an enormous treasure house of art and sculptures. And there are a lot of temples, a lot of shrines, gompas, and the iconic symbolism of mother goddesses is a very big hallmark of Kathmandu, I would say. And we can find so many statues, small statues, big statues, temples around the mother goddesses, such as Bhavani, Durga, Gajalakshmi, Harit Sheetala, Mahishamardini, and Saptamatrika, seven mother goddesses. So I would say it is actually 1 week's time, or at least 10 days' time for an Indian visitor, can have even more than that. But I think 10 days' time is a good enough to visit around Kathmandu, inside Kathmandu, inside the alleys, inside the temples, and the places, and get a feel of the place. And in fact, Kathmandu is also very popular. It has remained popular realms within Bollywood as well.
Yes, rightly mentioned. I also want to ask you about, because I have read that more of the ethnicity of the country and the city is Hinduism and Buddhist people. So what about the cuisine? Or vegetarian, actually.
Well, the staple food of Nepal is dal and bhat, which is a plain rice and a yellow dal. But if one goes to the streets of Kathmandu, one can find momos, which is nothing but a Nepali version of the Tibetan dumplings. And that is also, momos is also a very popular fast food. And of course, Tibetan influence is there. So we also find chow mein on the streets of Kathmandu. But dal bhat still remains the staple, along with some, you know, chutneys and the pickles. And food, cuisine-wise, I would not say it's a delight, but it's a mix of South Asian cuisine all around the Kathmandu city. And you find Indian food also, Chinese, Tibetan, and some of the very few international food chains are also available. And of course, vegetarian foods is also available. And but you may not find a great menu out there, but a simple vegetarian meal is plentiful available, because Kathmandu is also a temple town. And interestingly, Kanchan, it is also a sister city of our Varanasi. And that makes it a wonderful town in terms of the religious mysticism and religious tour as well.
Well, yes, I have heard that this is sister city of Varanasi. But at this point of time, I would like to ask you, suppose few people, they generally masses go to visit the temples and inclined towards pilgrimage and religious thoughts. But there are some other travelers who may not want to visit temples. And so anything is there for them? Like any sport or any climbing or any trekking venue for them?
So, yes, Kanchan. So as I said, Kathmandu is about South Asian culture's melting pot. So there is a lot of cultural influences from this region. And apart from the temples and the museums, there are a lot of heritage buildings are there. For example, Ghantaghar is one place, Dharahara is one place, and Singha Darbar, couple of old Nayanhiti Palace, Hanuman Doka Palace. There are places of historical interest. There are places of course, Nepal tourism conducts a lot of trekking, hiking in the deep Himalayas. And of course, the travel towards Everest starts from Kathmandu. The applications are accepted there. And Kathmandu Airport is actually one of the very challenging airports for landing. By road, I have traveled by road from Raxaul to Kathmandu, which is called a Tribhuvan Highway. And in between, I remember, Kanchan, there used to be a place, probably a place called Hetauda, where on the top of a Hetauda, the roads, the winding roads up in the Himalayas, one can actually count 80 roads down when the bus is at the top. And that view is spectacular. It is out of this world view. And reaching from Raxaul to Kathmandu is almost like a 6 hours of journey in a normal conditions. And therefore, now it is well connected. Raxaul is well connected and Kathmandu is well connected by air, by road. And the best part is that for Indians, we do not need passport to enter Nepal.
Yes, because we have a lot of similarities when we talk about Nepal, and we think that, yes, Nepal is a kind of a part of our nation. At this point of time, I also want to ask you that what is the art and architecture we are talking about a few minutes before? So the influence of art and architecture is more of Indian, or it's a mix of Buddhist and Hinduism, or maybe a touch of Chinese influence on the art and architecture of Nepal?
Well, Kanchan, art and architectural part of, especially seen in Kathmandu. I mean, we are talking about Kathmandu in focus. So there are three major periods there, of evolution, depending on which kingdoms or which big communities ruled that part of the country. So one is the Lichwi or the classical period is there. Then there is a post-classical period. And the modern one, which is started at 1400s onwards, it is called the Malla period. And there is a lot of influence on the Tibetan demonology. So a lot of dragons, a lot of Tibetan demons. That is part of the stupas and the temples and the arches. And of course, there is a religious art is also there. And it can be seen in various temples, palaces. And there are a lot of folk tales. When the kings used to live, there was even a tale of their certain families from the king were not supposed to visit certain temples because it is cursed for them. So, you cannot separate the temples and Buddhism temples, the Hindu temples, Changu Narayan temple, Bodhnath temple. Rani Pokhri is one of the very famous pond, a very old and very famous pond somewhere built around 1600s of time. And Buddha Nilkant is a very place in my, when I was a kid, it was told that Buddha Nilkant is a very haunted kind of a place for the certain families. And one special thing that I want to mention, Kanchan, is that when I was in a school and I used to visit Nepal on the way towards Kathmandu, I used to see every shop, every hotel, every shopping complex is having the photos of the king and the queen in the background. So that shows the dedication towards the kings, the Rana kings and Gorkha kings of that area. And India has great ties. It has always been a great ties from our several of our small princely states directly having relations with the Nepal's kingdoms. And in recent times, we have seen Bollywood and our famous Koirala, Manisha Koirala, from Nepal's political family, first political family. So yes, it is a great, great place. And Kathmandu is a visit, not just once.
Yes, it is a wonderful city and it is a destination that one should always visit at least once in lifetime. So it was great talking to you and know about your experience of this particular city. We'll be meeting again with our next destination and discuss other wonderful city. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.
Thank you, Kanchan. Have a great day ahead. And thank you for reminding me of Kathmandu, and I will visit soon.
We have some unique Akulmec memorabilia which will make you look outstanding. The graphics on these corporate gifts are based on the global best business practices. To become recipient of one of these gifts for free, you have to watch this video till the end and provide your valuable comments, or you can also share your experiences. The person who makes the best comment would be chosen to become a recipient of this beautiful Akulmec gift, absolutely free, delivered to your doorsteps. The winner would also get a chance to be invited live as a distinguished panelist during our next video. What are you waiting for, friends? Please subscribe Akulmec and smash that like button.